The other day, a friend of mine said, why do we keep hearing about the generations? He said, I don't even believe in them. It got me pretty upset. If you want to hear why I believe in the generations, stay tuned. You know, I've been studying the generations for over a decade right now, and I believe that right now, more than ever, when we study the generations, we get into the core of cultural diversity. I'll say it again. Generations are really helping us understand the core of cultural diversity. Let me explain. When we talk about the generations, many times we just think about the age. You know, what age are you? And that age determines your generation. But there's a lot more to it than age. When we look at the generations, to me, I believe that if we study young people, we're going to get a glimpse into the future. So let's start. We've got age, but let's move on to number one, the defining moments. Think about it. When you were a teenager, because they talk about the ages between 10 and 18, these are the most impressionable years where we form our perceptions. Things happen in the world, and these are defining moments. I know for me, I hate to give away my age, but when I was a small kid, the number one defining moment was the death, the assassination, really, of Robert F. Kennedy. From there, it was the Vietnam War, and there were other things that really impressed me. And when I got a little bit older, it was the man walking on the moon, right? The first guy on the moon. So think about it. What were your defining moments? Because it's these moments that we all share. It's our age, sure, but it's moments in time and history that we begin to share. And we begin to then have those feelings that are pretty much the same. Number two, it's the social shifts that are going on. Yeah, the socialization, the things that are changing, not just those defining moments, but actually social shifts that are happening during our informative years. Let's think of a couple right now. It could be Roe versus Wade when we talked about abortion, or it could be women going back to work. Generation X, many of those moms, their Generation X moms went back to work, giving them a lot of freedom at home. It could be the Civil Rights Act that was signed in the 70s. And more recently, it was the death of George Floyd. Think about that. And all of the protests that came about after his death. These are huge social shifts that are going on. So when we think about the generations, yeah, it's about their age, but it's these defining moments and it's these social shifts that really define a generation. And then, of course, there's technology. If you really begin to think about the advancements of technology, and today they say the world is changing faster than ever, all of that has to do with technology. So we can go all the way back to maybe your grandparents, traditionalists, where there was no technology at all. Maybe they turned, there was a knob for turning on the radio because they listened to the radio. That was about it. As the generations grow, as we move through the generations, we start to watch the increase of technology from the birth of the internet to social media, and we begin to see how that technology today is really defining our lives. And lastly, it's the parents. Yeah, mom and dad, it's us. It's the way the parenting ideas shifted and how each of us in each generation parented our children differently. All of these affect a generation. All of these are really the components that make a generation different from each other. And you know what? I believe that when we study the generations, we are giving ourselves a competitive edge. A competitive edge to understanding where the future is going. I have a quick story to tell from me. I am a baby boomer, and I've been speaking for about 10 years. When the Great Recession hit in 2008, 2009, I actually had no work. And there was this 23-year-old African-American in our town. Her name was Crystal Washington. And Crystal was a guru on the Facebook back then. She knew Facebook. She was helping people grow their businesses through social media using Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. And I decided that I needed to learn some more. It was a time when I had no work. Why not learn something new? I gave Crystal a call. And it was interesting because when we first met, she said to me, you know, I'd love to teach you all of this, but she said, what I need from you is I want to learn how to become a speaker. The two of us, totally different generations, totally different perspectives on life, got together. And in those years following the recession, we created a company called Social Tunities. And we got on stages teaching people, mostly baby boomers and Gen X, the value of social media and how to use it in your business. Today, Crystal is a huge international speaker. And I've got to admit, I'm not that bad on social media. that was a time when I needed to find someone to help me. And if I'd gone with who was comfortable, someone in my own generation who I understood, here's what I would have probably gotten. Information and ideas that I already knew. Crystal shook my world. She said I had to learn something new, and she opened my eyes to the future. So why am I telling you all this today? Because I believe we are at a time right now, a time that is so rich in generational diversity. It's a time for each of us to put down our put down, so to speak, and to open our minds to new generations and begin to learn from people who are older and younger than us. I hope this one helped you guys. I'm Karen McCullough with another lesson from the road.